So let's get started. I'm going to use two foundations here. I'm using Studio Fixes and it's in NC40 and 42. And I'm going to mix it up with a little bit of strobe cream. I like to apply the strobe cream before and mix it in with the foundation as well. So I'm just applying the NC40 here and I'm going to apply it all over the face. I'm using Studio Fix because I want a pretty much a matte coverage, not too much shine. And then I'm going to take my Real Technique brush and I'm going to take the NC42 and just apply it like a contour, really, but not really that harsh. It's just a light contour, still providing me coverage on those places, but just a darker shade. And obviously, this is just like one shade darker, it's an NC42. If you wanted to use a shade, two, three shades darker, then that's up to you. But I'm just kind of going by the picture that I have in mind from the film. So there wasn't much in the way of dark contouring. Okay, then I'm gonna set that with some powder from Sleek. This just came with the Sleek foundation. So I'm just, yeah. And then I'm gonna take eye base, Prep & Prime eye base in Light from MAC, and I'm applying that all over my eyelids just so my eyeshadow doesn't crease and lasts a little bit longer. And then here I've taken Illamasqua cream pigment, and it's a metallic-y bronzy color. I'll put the name down below, and I'm applying that all over the lids. I'm patting it in because I don't really want to move too much underneath, like in terms of the primer or anything. And then I'm going to take the gold color from Urban Decay palette. You can use any true gold, like I'm talking like a really true, not too much of a yellowy gold, but just a very rich gold. And I'm applying that onto the cream base and just blending that outwards. So it's going to cover the whole lid basically. And then I'm going to take my Hourglass bronzer, only because I just want a matte brown color, and this was first thing at hand. And I'm going to apply that into the crease of my eye. So and then after we've done that to both eyes, I'm taking a Barium pigment. This is just an iridescent pearlesque color, and I'm going to apply that to the brow bones. And I'm not applying too much because back in the day or back then, I don't think there was a lot of highlighting used, but obviously this is inspired, so I'm just going to adapt it however I think it will suit me best, so you guys can do the same. And here I've taken Dipdown Gel Eyeliner by MAC, and I'm just going to define my eyebrows. And I'm sorry that it goes out of focus here, but I'll probably do another video on eyebrows. And there's plenty of videos on eye routines available if you want to see. But I just didn't fill them in over. I didn't overfill them in, and I just kind of filled them in more at the arch and define the arch, but not so much in the beginning. And yeah, brush them through. So they look a little bit more groomed. I like to brush them through after when I'm using gel because it just softens it. And then ahead with the eyeliner. So there's plenty of winged eyeliner tutorials available. I'm just using a felt tip eyeliner by MAC. It's from the Wonder Woman collection. And just create a thin line and just thicken it up once you're comfortable with it. Like so. And then I'm going to take my Black Track gel eyeliner and I'm just going to elongate that eyeliner to give more of a retro flick. And then curl the lashes. And now I'm going to use a Rimmel pencil. It's just in nude, and I'm using that in the waterline. And then, of course, lashings and lashings of mascara. I am going to pop on some false lashes. Now with false lashes, if you can bend the packaging so you don't end up distorting the shape of the eyelash. And my favourite glue, duo glue, and then just pop those on. There we go, eyelashes are on. And I'm just going to go over with black eyeshadow, or you can use gel liner, and just kind of hide the seal mark or any glue marks with that. And then I'm taking my MAC Full Coverage Foundation in C40 and just going over under the eyes to basically provide some coverage under there. You can use a concealer, but the MAC Full Coverage Foundations are literally full coverage, so you don't really need a concealer. And then I'm going to use the same bronzer. Sorry, I think someone was disturbing me. I'm going to use the same bronzer to contour. And I love this bronzer because it is matte and it is not too harsh. Of course, you can build it up as much as you want, but I kept it quite soft. I'm just taking that up through the temples and then the jawline as well. And then I'm gonna take one of my favorite blushes, which is Pinch Me by MAC, which is just one of those blushes that works for a lot of different skin tones, and it's just dead easy to wear. So I apply that to the apples of the cheeks and then just kind of blend it into your contour. And my favorite part, the lips. I'm using MAC's Cherry Liner, and it's just my favorite go-to red lip liner. Goes with a bazillion types of red lipsticks, and it just doesn't distort the color of them too much, which I like. And I also like to fill my lips in with the same liner just for extra depth and staying power. And I was going to use Ruby Woo on top, but I thought it was too vibrant, and the kind of classic retro Bollywood look wasn't so much a blood red, but more of a classic deep red. So there we go, red lips done, and I'm just going to use a Viva Glam lipstick. It's a beautiful deep burgundy red, and just to kind of deepen the cherry lip liner, because I did feel it was too modern, let's say. And then on top of that, I'm using a gloss from LA Colors, really cheap, but it's like a metallic-y deep red gloss. And then I've just taken the same gold eyeshadow that I used on my lids, and I'm adding it to the center part of my lips just to give that extra volume if you want it. And one more step, definitely can't forget adding the Bindi. So I'm just using the same liner, but if you've got this a red Bindi, then great, but I didn't have one, so we got to improvise. So there you go, that's the red Bindi on. I'm just gonna let my hair down. And there you go, that's the finished look. Just to go with the kind of visual that I have, I'm just literally gonna put my fro of a hair into a low kind of a low sleek bun. Don't ask what I was doing there. I think I was really feeling the theme. So there you go, put my hair slick back down, and that's the finished look. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it was helpful. It's just such a simple, easy look to do. And yeah,